Hi everyone. Before I recorded my novel, nearly 111 chapters, 11 episodes, and it was a long journey. So now I thought I should record short stories. These short stories are based on illegal immigrants. Before I tell you the introduction about these short stories, what kind of stories I have written, I would like to add few things. There are three ways to become legal in European, American, Australia, New Zealand, wherever there are people think that they can go for the betterment of their life. The first is you can do a paper marriage. It is in fact a real marriage, but it's a contract marriage. Once you have the papers, you divorce her or she will give you divorce. And for the paper marriage, you have to pay for that. It's not Oriental people or the Arabs or the people from poor countries, they do paper marriage. Even French, German, Italian, they used to go to America to get green card. They used to do paper marriage as well. So it's a human instinct that we search for the betterment of our life, from one place to another place. It's called migration. And the second thing is you apply political asylum, which is normally 99.99% based on fake documents and fake stories, but this is the way to become legal. And if they accept your political stay, then you are legal in these countries. And the third thing is you stay in some country for 5 years, 10 years or 14 years, and finally their amnesty commission, they give you the papers. It depends on every country and vary upon your situation. There are so many other ways to become legal in these countries, but these are for the illegal immigrants. And it's not a joke when you leave your country and you become an illegal immigrant. When you come to these countries, there are so many things which you face: language, culture, civilization. You leave your loved ones, and some people, while they are living here illegally, they have bad impact of this situation, and some people they get the good impact of this situation. So it affects on you either in a good way or in a bad way. Some people they adapt these things and some people they are unable to adapt. And finally, when they are settled, then they think that they found that they are Muslim, they are Christian, they are Jew, or they are Hindu or Buddhist. So I will start now the introduction of my short stories. The title is Immigrants or Slaves. Immigrants or slaves, migration to solve your economic problems, or slavery of your desires and wishes, migration with our own will or forcefully. Humankind is migrating since ages. Slaves, merchants, nomads, prophets, warriors, and common people are traveling from one place to another place for religious expansion, wider their boundaries. Humankind invent excuses to travel or migrate to other countries for commerce, religious monks, missionaries, or invading countries. They always wanted to find new places, new lands for betterment of their lives. You just imagine humankind start immigration or migration many centuries ago and still migrating. In 19th century, human migration was on its peak. Even every 10th person was immigrant, which means out of 100, 10 were immigrants, which is a very high ratio. People were migrating not in groups of thousands, but in millions. In the beginning of the 19th century, there is an island called Ellis Island, which is part of American state New York. That island was central place of immigrants. From this island, people used to travel to United States of America, Canada, Australia, Argentina, surely for the betterment of their lives. Now immigrants have many options and ways to migrate to other countries. Not like before. According to immigration analysis department, in 2002, nearly 175 million people left their homeland or country for the betterment of their life or for the good jobs. Now people don't gather in Ellis Island to go to USA, Canada, or Australia. Now they go to Europe, Japan, Scandinavian countries. According to the last and recent analysis about immigration, migration and immigrants, the percentage of migration and immigration is 3% of total population. It means every 98th, 99th, and 100th person is immigrant. These are the analysis about those people who are on the record or they are in written form. Today, if you try to make the map about immigrants and migration, then you will find it's very difficult because immigrants are all around the world. They are everywhere like web of spider. You will find a Pakistani immigrant in Fiji Island and an Afghan immigrant in Switzerland. People from underdeveloped countries move to these desirous countries, to their desirous countries. How do they enter in European countries, in United States of America, Canada or Australia? I'm not talking about the legal immigrants. I'm talking about illegal immigrants who love to come to these countries by illegal means. The people who bring them are called agents or people broker. The people who are acquainted with immigration or they are immigrants, they must know this word called donkey, means crossing the border illegally. These groups or gangs are very well organized, who are agents or people broker, who are working to help illegal immigrants to cross the border illegally. Usually people have misconception that European Americans or Australians aren't corrupt and they aren't involved in this risky business. They aren't involved in this risky business of illegal immigration or migration. You would be shocked after knowing the facts that 99% in this business and behind every illegal immigration, they are working with great passion, but they are behind the curtain. As there are Pakistani, Indian, Chinese, and South American agents on the other hand, there are European, American, and Australian agents as well on the other side of the curtain. They work together and collaborate with each other. Wherever you have to cross the border, there are agents. I'm talking about the illegal, crossing border illegally. In Pakistan, Iran, Turkey, Greece, Italy, or France, you would be flabbergasted to know that as the immigration laws are becoming strict, more people are migrating and more immigrants, and migration increased up to 4 million. These 4 million people are those who are illegal immigrants or transferred by illegal means by agents or people brokers, sometime in form of immigrants or sometime in form of slaves. It's not the business of $1 million, but it's the business of $1 billion. So immigrants are ordinary people. They are very important and precious for the people broker and agents. Nearly every illegal immigrant pays $5,000 to $10,000, even more than that. An Italian or region American citizen who work for United States, United Nations Immigration and Migration Department, according to his analysis, 200 million people are trapped by these people brokers, which is huge amount. For example, in 2000, in the month of June, a truck of tomatoes was going to England, crossing English Channel via Dover. There were 50 Chinese inside the truck. They lost their lives. Exactly after 1 week, 46 Somalians lost their lives going to England via Hungary. Few years ago, two Indians were hidden in aeroplanes' wheels. This was the unique style of migration from India to United Kingdom. One of them lost his life. One of them lost his life during voyage. and other must have been in the hospital because there are no news about him. These are all stories which became news. People heard about them. But what about those stories which we don't know? They don't reach to the public. There is no record about them. We only know and hear about people who are on the record. Humankind has transferring from one place to another place as slave or immigrants since ages. It doesn't matter if he is a masculine, feminine, eunuch or transgender. Some of them brought by people broker from poor countries to Europe, America, Australia or Canada for prostitution, either female, male or transgender. Some agents bring kids of 13 to 15 years old for homosexuality, pedophilia and child molestation. Nearly every year, 2 million girls and women migrate to these rich and so-called civilized countries, or people broker brought them for prostitution. Among these 2 million girls, 0.5 million girls destiny is Europe and European countries, and among those 0.5 million girls, 50,000 go to Italy. Like these agents take their commission, which is $3,000 to $5,000 or euros, and then they use them for prostitution and make more money. Behind all this money is involved. Everyone has become greedy for the money and everyone wants to become rich overnight. He doesn't care how or by which means he is making money. He only wants to become rich as soon as possible. He doesn't care about feelings, respect, values, norms, and traditions. You just imagine the one who can pay 5,000 or 10,000 euros for crossing the border illegally, and he pay to agent or broker, he is not a poor man, he is not a poor person. So you can say in Europe, Italy is the paradise of illegal immigrants, or you can say hell. You have to decide it's paradise or hell. We call them clandestine, they are like predators. As predators hide themselves and attack an illegal immigrants or clandestine, hide themselves, they show themselves when there is possibility to get papers or to get legal documents. In Italian language, word clandestini is like curse, as someone called you bastard. There are six main routes to enter in Europe. Among those six routes, four of them are in Italy. It's same like Ellis Island. All these illegal immigrants gather in nearest island of Italy. As they find some solution or means to escape, they travel to different places of Europe. 90% enter in European countries. In last 10 to 15 years, Italy opened immigration many times and they call it sanatoria or amnesty for illegal immigrants. So there are many immigrants who started coming to Italy and they started living here. There are two islands between Libya and Italian island, Sicily. Between Libya and Italian island, Sicily, these islands are called Lampedusa and Pantelleria. Most illegal immigrants come to these islands. Then they enter in Sicily, Calabria or Lecce. Agents and people broker make a lot of money by doing illegal immigration, illegal trafficking of people, male, female or transgender. Coming to Europe is a one-way ticket. Single ticket, no return ticket. It's not cheap. There is no discount in this illegal border crossing voyage. The most richest people of the world are selling arms illegally or legally, like countries like America, France or Germany. They sell these arms by agents or by illegal means. Second biggest business in is drug business, which at certain extent legally, but people do it illegally, and big countries are involved in that. Third biggest business in the world is completely illegal, and this business is illegal trafficking of immigrants. So immigrants are at third place, which is a big thing. So three big businesses, selling arms is the highest, you can make billions. And second is selling drugs, and bringing people illegally is the third highest biggest business in the world. Thank you very much. I hope you like my video. Like my video, subscribe my channel, and press the bell icon. And from now on, I will record the short stories which are related with these things which I have mentioned to you in my introduction. Thank you very much.